Okay. Good evening, everybody. Michael Falk here at Falk This Nonsense. Thank you all for being here this evening. I am live on Facebook Live on this camera, TikTok over on this camera over here, and Instagram Live on this camera here. So thank you all for being here across the board. For those of you that don't know me, let me take a minute to introduce myself. My name is Michael Falk, obviously, and I am a retired Navy Chief Petty Officer who now makes his living as an artist. This is what I do. I am the former assistant art director for Mad Magazine. I've been a digital production artist for DC Comics. I've done animation for Mad Magazine and Warner Brothers Consumer Products, and I did an internship at Nickelodeon back in the day. I do have a degree in animation, and I actually have my own startup animation studio that I run here in Buffalo, New York. So back when I lived in LA, I used to teach painting live for one of the paint and sip companies. And I enjoyed myself. I think I was pretty good at it. And I had a lot of fun. I had a lot of return guests and built a bit of a following. Moving back east and going through the pandemic is, you know, I've kind of like, I lost touch with some of that stuff. So I'm starting to do it again. I figured, why not get on here on social media and just start painting with people again? It's completely free. It doesn't cost you anything. I'm going to walk you through this stuff step by step. Have a lot of fun with y'all. And hopefully you guys will finish up with a painting that you can be really happy with and, you know, hang somewhere in your house, whether it's above the mantle or above the bed or above the toilet, whatever. It's entirely up to you. Garage, I don't care. Whatever. So tonight we are going to be painting Rainbow Hummingbird. One of our one of my followers, I think it was one of my followers on TikTok last week, made a special request. Said, hey, can we paint a hummingbird? Absolutely. And if any of you are painting tonight or you're just stopping by and logging in to see what's going on, if you have something in particular that you'd like to paint, drop it in the comments on any one of the platforms here. I check the comments periodically. I will be more than happy to accommodate you. I will come up with an original painting that you can then come and paint with me. So everything that I paint here is original, so you don't have to worry about having painted it before, I can tell you that. But we're gonna go ahead and get started here, guys. So thank you all for being here. Again, TikTok and Instagram and Facebook over here. Oh, Facebook's actually up here, but the computer's down there, but whatever. You know what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's have a little bit of fun. All right, now I'm gonna introduce you to some of the tools that we are gonna be using to work tonight. The first thing I wanna introduce you to is our brushes. Now I've got what is known as what I call a large rectangle brush. And then I call a small round brush. It's a round brush is basically round this way. All right, and this is a rectangle brush. But what I want to show you all is the size. In this case, the size really doesn't matter. All right, it's how you use the brush. You can use any different size of rectangle brush. Use a little half inch wide one or a quarter inch wide one or, you know, 1 inch wide one or even a half inch wide long one. All right, you can use any size of round brush. Long bristles, short bristles, small round brush, any one of these will work with the brush strokes that I'm going to show you. So if you have one of these or one of these, it doesn't matter. As long as you get the brush strokes right, you'll be good to go, okay? So let's set those down. I'm gonna be using these two tonight. I've got my large rectangle and my small round. I've also got two buckets of water, all right? Now, I usually paint with just one, but tonight, I'm gonna be painting with two buckets of water because if you look at our sample there, we've got a lot of wash coming down. We've got a lot of water that we're going to be applying to the canvas. So I'm going to save one bucket of water and keep it clean just for applying water to the canvas to give you some of these nice dripping striations in the paint. All right, so this, you will only ever dip a clean brush into this. You'll use this one to clean all of your color out. All right, let's set those aside. Okay, I've got my palette that I'm going to be using tonight. Okay, all the colors are on my palette. I've got blue, yellow, red, black, and white. So as long as you got a palette, that's fine. It can be a paper plate, it can be a styrofoam plate, whatever you want. Or, you know, if you're a pro and you've got a big palette like me, you know, go ahead, use it, all right? Make sure you have your palette, all right? We wanna have a rag or a paper towel in order to wipe and clean our brushes off. Obviously, we want our paints. I've got black and white and yellow, and I've got some red. And I've got a cobalt blue tonight. I just chose cobalt blue because I like the way it looks. If you've got an ultramarine or another blue, that's absolutely fine. Blue, for this application here, for a nice rainbow color, blue is blue, whatever. All right, I will show you how to use those paints to get the desired effect. And the last thing, obviously, is our canvas. We've got our canvas and my easel here. If you don't have an easel, you can prop it up against, you know, a box or your significant other or a dog, whatever. If you can get your dog to like fall asleep there and just prop the canvas up, that works too. All right. But one thing that's going to be important for tonight in particular, because of this composition and because of the amount of water that we're going to be washing down on this, on my easel here, you see I've got paper towels up underneath. You see they've already got paint on them because this is the easel that I used to paint this yesterday. But I've got paper towels down here to capture any excess water. But what you can't see is down on my floor, I've got these nice wood floors here, I've got newspaper laid down below. So you're going to want to have something underneath your canvas to catch any excess water that drips down. Now, if you get, you know, if you get any of this paint on your like tile floor or linoleum floor or a wood floor, it'll scrape right up once it dries, no big deal. If you have a carpet floor, you're going to want to make sure that you have something underneath that canvas to catch it, okay? So there we go. Those are the tools that we're going to use tonight. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start my paint night, or my paint event. I can't call it paint night. It's NIGHT. It's my paint NIGHT night. I'm going to start that the same way I've started every other painting event that I've ever done, even the live events that I did out west. If you've painted with me before, you know this. I like to toast. I'm going to start with a toast, and then I will toast all throughout the evening, mostly because I like to drink and I don't like to drink alone. So there you go. So let's start with a favorite Irish toast. That is kind of endearing to me. Here we go. Here's to our spouses and our lovers. May they never meet. Cheers. All right, everybody, what do you say we go ahead and get started here? Now, what I want you all to see on our sample here is I'm working in a rainbow fashion. I've got my red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and violet. All right, you ready for this? My Roy G. Biv. Everybody knows Roy G. Biv, right? All the way across. However, in order to get this beautiful dripping striation in our background, I'm gonna wanna start all the way down here in the bottom right-hand corner with my purple and my violet, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure I've got a little bit of blue and a little bit of red on my palette. Put a little bit of blue, a little bit of red on my palette, bloop, just like that. And then I'm gonna take my large rectangle brush, this guy right here. Okay, now I know I said, I know I showed you guys this tiny little palette. This was just a joke. I saw this on Thingiverse and I had to throw it on a 3D printer, and you know, it's just something I mess with every week. I think it's hilarious to have that little tiny palette like that. But here's my real palette, okay? And again, you can use a styrofoam plate, paper towel, doesn't matter, all right? So let's go ahead and mix up a little bit of violet or purple. So I'm gonna take my red, pull a little bit of red over here where I can play with it, and I'm gonna start mixing some blue right on into that. As soon as you start bringing that blue in, whether it's your ultramarine or your cobalt, you can start to see we get a nice violet or purple color. Now watch what I do here, guys. So I'm gonna start down here in this corner, and what I want you to feel about this painting is that it's very abstract. It really is, okay? So there's really no way to mess it up or do it wrong, all right? You can have a little bit of canvas showing through in places, not that big a deal. Once we start making all this color drip down, nobody's gonna see any canvas that's hiding underneath. Trust me, they're not gonna see it. They're gonna be so entranced by the striations of color that are moving throughout your canvas, nobody's gonna care if you leave a couple of blank spots. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my large rectangle brush here. I'm gonna come down to the bottom right-hand corner. I'm just gonna very gently just start sweeping back and forth, just like this. And I'm gonna do like the corner, just like that, in this nice purple violet here. Ready for the next step? Now we're gonna work on these steps, each one of these steps a little quickly, because I don't want this to dry. I wanna take this brush, and I wanna wash it out in the one cup of water that I've saved for my washing. And now that I've got a clean brush, I'm gonna dip that brush into my clean water, all right? Always put a clean brush into this water here. Dip that in there. Now watch what I do here, guys. I'm going to introduce that water to my violet here, little at a time, and I'm going to start tapping it on there, and you start to see how the water starts to run down a little bit. All right? You'll start to see that water drip down and start to thin out your painting a little bit. It's okay in a painting like this to use quite a bit of water. You don't have to worry about how much you use. Let it drip down, let it really kind of flow a little bit, have a little bit of fun with it, really just enjoy the sensation of being able to be loose and relaxed with your painting. A lot of times, I know that some of you probably do the different paint and sip events, you know, that you can either do them live, you know, since the pandemic hit, they do them remotely as well. And a lot of people get really focused on, like, I gotta do this perfectly. And one of the things that I always really tried to instill in my guests when I was doing this live was that you really don't have to. You really don't. All right? This painting is going to be imbued with your personality, with whatever the day brought you, okay? Every time, like this, I painted this yesterday. When I paint this one tonight, it's going to be entirely different than this one. You can already see that it's different. You can already see that the violet is different. You already see that the wash is different. Because every time you paint something, it is going to be imbued with your feeling, your emotion, your personality for that particular moment in time, okay? It doesn't have to be perfect, guys. We're just here having a little adventure. I'm just your guide on this little adventure. We're just out here to have some fun, so let's have some fun, okay? Now, what I want to do next is I'm going to go ahead and wash out my brush and get it nice and clean. I am going to be working on this background a little quickly. I'm going to try not to go too quick. I don't want you guys to feel like I'm rushing you along. If anybody feels like I've moved along too quickly, or if you need me to back up and redo a step, just drop it in the comments and let me know. I'll be happy to slow down, go back and handle the step. But the reason I want to kind of get the background down a little quickly is because we need all of this, all of the striations of water that are dropping down, we need that to dry quite a bit before we come in here and start putting in our flowers and our hummingbird. We want that background to be dry so we don't pick up any of that color and create brown. That's the one kind of caveat for what we're doing here tonight. We're working with every single primary color and black and white. And if we're not careful, if one area is still too wet and we try to go over it with another color, with one of its complementary colors opposite on the color wheel, we're going to create brown. All right, and we don't want any brown on our painting tonight. We want these nice, beautiful, bright colors. So let me go ahead and take my large rectangle brush and let me pull a little bit of that blue that I've already got on my palette here. All right, I'm just gonna pull some of that blue aside. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna come in here and I'm just gonna start washing some blue in side to side on an angle like this. Now you'll notice again, there's a gap. There's white canvas in between my blue and my violet there. Why is that? Because I'm going to wash this out. I'm going to pick up some clean water. Right? I'm going to pick up some nice clean water and I'm going to wash across my blue like this with my clean water. See how my blue is starting to wash down? My blue is washing down into the white area. And it's also washing down into my violet. That's what I want. Just like I've got here, I've got where the orange comes down across the yellow and the green and the blue. As we move these colors around, these colors are going to stay on top of one another and start to wash down to the colors underneath. And it's really going to look sharp and beautiful when it's done. All right? You should be applying just enough water so that you really can't see any brush strokes anymore. Okay? And really, with a technique like this, as long as you've got something underneath your canvas, there really is no such thing as too much water. Okay? As long as you can't make a mess on your carpet, or, you know, your kids or your pets, whatever happens to be underneath your canvas, there's really no such thing as too much water. All right, so let's have a little bit of fun with it. Let's wash it. Let's wash some more blue down here a little bit. Okay, now, if you are washing the color down and you notice that the water keeps following one or two particular channels, there's a really easy way to get around that. You can cheat it a little bit. You can take your brush and you can go ahead and actually create a channel by tapping vertically in an area and then actually creating another channel for the water to flow down, just like that. Okay? So there we go. Once we're done with that step, we can go ahead and wash out that brush and get it nice and clean. Now I'm going to take a minute, let you guys get caught up. All right? I'm going to check the comments section, see if anybody's got any questions, see if anybody's got any concerns. And then, before we get started with the next step, we'll go ahead and kick off with another toast. All right? So let me check the comments here really quickly. How's everybody doing over here on Facebook? Outstanding. Any questions, comments? No, looks pretty good. I see a lot of people over here on TikTok. Thank you, everybody, for being here. The Crazy Bear, Duck Up. My friends over at Squirty Cats, thanks for being here, guys. I really do appreciate it. Thank you for stopping by. Over here on Instagram, we got quite a few people watching. The Blooming Vase and Camillo and Frenja and Nicolettis. That's an interesting name, Nicolettis. And Anid is here. Thanks, Anid, for coming back. All right. My good friend, yes, I am absolutely doing the jig. Yes. And you know what? I don't want to go up too high because I am wearing my kilt today, Brett. All right, I'm absolutely wearing my kilt as I do always. Actually, I think I've been wearing this kilt for a month straight now. But I am traditional, so it's, you know, everything's nice and clean and good to go underneath. Don't worry about it. All right, so Brett, thanks for stopping by, brother. It's really, really great to have you out here. Hopefully, you're painting with us tonight. If not, come back every Friday night. I paint a new and different painting every Friday night. For those of you that just joined us, I do painting sessions like this, free painting sessions. Doesn't cost you anything. Just as long as you've got the supplies, I will walk you through a new painting every Friday night at 9 p.m. Eastern. I used to do them at 8 p.m. Eastern, but now I'm doing them at 9 p.m. Eastern because I do have some friends and some followers out on the West Coast that want to be able to get off of work and then come paint with me. So if I do it at 9 p.m. here, that's 6 p.m. there, and it works out pretty well. So we're going to be doing these every week at 9 p.m., new painting, different painting, every single week. All of them are going to be easy. All of them are going to be fun. Just come on out and paint with me, all right? So let's get ready for the next step. For those of you that are painting along with me, let's go ahead and take our large rectangle brush, nice and clean. We've washed it out. And the next color I want to do is my green. Now, I don't have any green in my paint, guys. I've got my primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. All right, so I've got to mix up a little bit of green. If you've got green at home, if you're using green, that's absolutely fine. You can use your own green, but I like to mix as I go. I like to be able to mix my own colors so that I can get the color that I'm looking for, because you can mix an infinite number of, you know, shades of green or shades of purple all the way along. So I like to be able to do this myself. I'm gonna pull a little bit of yellow off to the side here. I'm gonna take a little bit of blue and just start blending that blue in. I got this nice cobalt blue. Ooh, look at that. Gives me a nice sort of easy lime green. Now with that easy lime green here, I'm gonna go ahead and start sweeping across, again on an angle from side to side. Pull up a little bit more of this paint, just like this. And you'll notice that I'm doing these blocks in, you know, just a couple of inches at a time. I want to make sure that I've got enough room to go all the way from my yellow, my orange, and my red, all right? But if you've got a particularly favorite color, if you like green or you like blue, you can make that a little bit wider. If you like red, you can do like I did up here. I made a big spot of red up here moving into the orange. That's absolutely fine, all right? Again, you're painting. You enjoy it, you have fun, you make it what you want it to be, all right? Once we've got that green on the canvas there, we're gonna go ahead and wash this out, get it nice and clean. Get all that green out of there, make a clean brush, and then we're gonna dip into our clean water, our nice clean water cup there, and we are gonna start bringing some water into the canvas. We're gonna introduce just straight water right across there, let some of our green start to float down. All right, that green is gonna wash all the way down over the blue, down into the purple. All right, now as we're doing this, these colors, the blue and the purple, are drying. So when the green starts to wash over it, it'll wash through those colors, all right? And it won't blend with them. So you'll get these really, really beautiful kind of lines of green coming through your blue and lines of green coming through your purple. You also get some lines of blue coming through your purple. You got some really, really gorgeous colors that start getting created here as you wash these down, okay? Yeah! I lose your love. Yes, I do karaoke painting. I'm sorry, it is what it is. I listen to 80s music in the background and you will catch me singing some songs from time to time. So if anybody's bothered by that, I apologize ahead of time. But if you know the song, sing it along with me. Why the hell not, all right? So I promised you guys a toast before I moved on to this next step, and I completely forgot to do that, and I apologize for that. So I'm gonna share a toast with you all right? One of my favorites, before we move on to the next step. Here's to a long life and a happy one, a quick death and an easy one, a good lover and an honest one, a stout whiskey, and another one. Cheers. Outstanding. Thank you all for being here tonight. I hope you're all having a wonderful, wonderful time. I'm going to take a minute to check my comments and see who's here. Jane, thanks for being here, Jane. It's nice to see you. Cheers. Thank you for being here tonight. I hope you're painting with us, and if you're a little late and you need me to back up and do some of the steps over or redemonstrate them, please let me know. I'll be happy to do that for you. All right. Joni over on Facebook, I'm glad you like it. I hope you're painting with us tonight, I can't wait to see. I'll be honest with you, Joni. last week when I saw your painting. So, guys, the rest of you out here in the rest of the social media world, I used to teach Paint Night out in L.A., and I did that for about 6 years live and built up a little bit of a following. And I had one painter that obviously had artistic talent, but she didn't really do a lot of painting. So she showed up one day and just started painting with me and did an okay job. And then she showed up another time, and then she kept coming back, and she became a regular. Joni, a good friend of mine now, kept painting with me over and over again. And every single time she painted, she got better and better and better. And guess what? Now she teaches painting, all right? And she's really good at it. So she painted with us last week, and she took the painting that I demonstrated and took it to another level altogether. It looked amazing, it really did. So when she showed that to me, I said, you know what? I really need to up my game for this week's painting. Maybe I'm being too basic for my friends out here in, you know, in social media. Let me have a little bit of fun with it this time. So that's why I created Rainbow Hummingbird here. I wanted to play with more techniques and more color and more shape. So Joni, thank you for that. That was all on you. I really do appreciate you. My Facebook camera's up here. Janie, thank you so much for helping with that. I do appreciate it. So how are we doing over here on Instagram? We got any questions over here, guys? I'm just looking to see if we got any questions or comments. Wonderful. All right, guys. What I'm getting ready to do next is move on to my next area of color. Now, I'm just following the rainbow, but I am doing it backwards. I got my Roy G. Biv here, but I wanted to start down here in the corner so that I can wash everything down to the bottom, like I'm doing here. So I'm gonna take my clean, large rectangle brush, and this time I'm just gonna dip into some straight yellow all by itself. Get a good amount of yellow on my brush, push that off to the side, and then I'm gonna take my yellow and I'm just gonna start bringing it in. Now, yellow's a little bit of a lighter color, it's a softer color. So you may have to just go in here and really just apply it a little bit and really work it into the canvas. But just like we did with all of the other colors that we're working with tonight, once we get our band of yellow in place, we're gonna go ahead and wash that brush out. And we're gonna pick up that clean water again. We're gonna take that clean brush, take our clean water, and just start bringing some water. We're gonna introduce some water right into our yellow and let our yellow start to blend down. It's gonna drip down, wash down into the green and into the blue. And again, if you've got an issue with where the wash is going, you can introduce your own wash points here. You can introduce these little drip points by just taking your brush and tapping into the yellow a little bit with a vertical brush. All right, that'll actually create a little channel for the water to run down. It's not so random as just doing it by applying water, but it works, it absolutely works. So you can do that if you'd like to. Now I got a little bit of other colors on here because I have some paint on my hands and I apologize for that. That color's not supposed to be there, but it is what it is. Yeah, that's coming out good. I really like the way this is working tonight. This is a fun painting. I really enjoyed painting this, and I'm really enjoying teaching it tonight. It's a really simple painting. I think I don't have as many people painting tonight as I thought I would, and I think that's because some people might have been intimidated by it, but I hope you guys are finding it really easy and fun tonight. So there you go. All right, so we've got our violet, our blue, our green, and our yellow, and we're washing that color down with clean water. All right, I'm gonna take a breather for just a second, just in case anybody needs to change their water out. Even with clean water, with only putting a clean brush into here, you are gonna get a little bit of paint. It happens, there's paint left over your brush. So I'm gonna change out my clean water for more clean water. I'm gonna take 2 minutes, take a break, change out my water. I'll be right back to move on to the next step. All right, see you guys in a minute. Immortal words of Bender B. Rodriguez, I'm back, baby! All right, here we go. So, who's ready for the next step? All right? We got here, just checking some comments and questions, see if anybody's got any comments really quickly to check. Thank you, Janie, I appreciate that compliment. Anid, I'm glad you're still here. Guys, what we're getting ready to do now is create some orange. All right, our red is going to be our last color that we create up here in the corner, but I need to bring some orange in. So I actually need some red and some yellow on my palette that I can play with here. Okay, so I've got some red and some yellow here. Now I want to make sure that the orange that I create is not too red. All right, and the reason for that is it's right next to my red, which means it's really going to be bright. The red is really going to be overpowering, so I just want to take a little bit of red, just a tiny bit, about the size of a Q-tip there, and blend it into some of that yellow to make a nice, soft, sort of creamsicle orange. All right, see that orange I've got there? I want a soft orange because it's going to be right next to that bright, bright red. So let's go ahead and bring that orange in right on top of that yellow. Avec moi. Anytime, any place, anywhere, anywhere. And again, just like we did earlier, once my orange band is in place, I'll wash that out, get it nice and clean. Hoybraten, oh my God. I think I've got an old CB on the channel here with me tonight. Guys, as I introduced myself earlier, I told you all that I was a retired Navy Chief Petty Officer. I was with the Navy Seabees, Navy Construction Battalion, for my entire career, and I made a lot of friends and served with a lot of great people, and I still am connected with quite a few of them on social media, and tonight it looks like one of them, is that Rich Hoybraten? Looks like Rich Hoybraten is over on Instagram. Rich, it's great to see you, sir. Thank you for being here, man. I miss you, and I hope you're doing well. And now I've got another buddy of mine, Ralphie. Ralphie, thanks for being here. Old friend of mine back from the high school days. I love seeing this. You know, just I meet a lot of new people, have a lot of fun with new people here, but I also get to see some of my old friends that just pop up to watch me paint. I think that's amazing. You guys are awesome. So before my paint dries too much, I'm going to get over here to see the comments in the other sections here in just a minute. But what I want to do is I want to make sure that I add that water. I'm going to drip that water over the orange and let that orange start to wash down. All right, let that orange wash down over my yellow. You'll see that my green and my blue are starting to dry, so my orange is going to wash all the way down into the green. I can get that orange to wash all the way down the canvas and really give me a beautiful, sort of flowing, almost a rainfall, if you will. All right, coming across the canvas like that. This is all clean water. All right, I wash my brush out in between because I've got one container that is just for washing the brush and one container that is just for adding clean water to the canvas like this here to get the dripping down the canvas. All right, so once I've done with the orange there, I'm going to go ahead and wash this brush out, get it nice and clean. I'm going to go ahead and take a minute, guys, to check my comments, see if anybody's got any questions or concerns. Oh, Seamus, outstanding. You're up here on TikTok. I hope I didn't miss you, man. It's great to have you here. Seamus Smith is a good friend of mine. Met a few years ago at Comic-Con. He's a phenomenal cartoonist and artist. So if you guys aren't following him, go take a look at stuff he's got on Instagram and over on TikTok as well. Seamus Smith Art. Seamus, the way the Irish spell it, you know what I mean? So go take a look at what he's got. Thanks for stopping by, Seamus. I do appreciate it. How's everybody doing over here on Facebook? I see we've got a few people over here. Thanks for being here, guys. I do appreciate it. Thank you so much. Those of you that are over here on Instagram, again, thank you for being here. If anybody's got any questions or comments, any concerns, if you need me to go back and redo a step, all you need to do is put it in the comments. I'll be happy to back up a little bit and re-demonstrate another technique or another step. All right, not a problem. So we're going to take a breather here for just a second. We are getting ready to do our red in just a moment, but I don't want you guys to feel like I'm moving too fast. I know that sometimes when I'm painting, I can give off a Bob Ross vibe. I am a little bit louder and more in your face than he is, and I move a little bit faster. I apologize. I bring him up because I did learn how to paint from Bob Ross back in the day on PBS, you know, the real way, not on YouTube. But I also, Bob Ross and I share a little bit of history as well. He was also retired senior enlisted for the military. He was a retired Air Force Master Sergeant who gained his love of painting by being stationed in bases in Alaska and Colorado and whatnot, and just, you know, excuse me. If you've ever served, you know that sometimes you get to a base where there's absolutely nothing going on, and you need to find something to keep you occupied. I learned horseback riding at Meridian, Mississippi, because there wasn't a goddamn thing going on in that town or on that base except for the bowling alley and the E-Club and the horseback riding, all right? So you get to learn a lot of neat things depending on where you are, and that's where he learned his love of painting, is in Colorado and Alaska. So there you go. All right, I'm going to check the comments here for just a second. Oh, of course, Seamus, absolutely. Anytime, man. You are a very talented artist, and I want more people to follow and see what you're doing. So, and I love seeing, I really do love seeing some of the stuff you're doing. It reminds me of sort of like a cross between R. Crumb and Sergio Aragonés, some of the stuff that you do. I really do love seeing it, so please keep doing that. All right, guys, so let's breathe for a second. Let's get ready for the next step here in just a moment. But before I do that, of course, we are going to have a toast. Again, I like to toast all throughout my evening, all throughout the event, mostly because I like to drink and I don't like to drink alone. So if you've got your favorite beverage, you can go ahead and toast along with me. So here's one. Let's see. Here's to hell. May your stay there be as fun as your way there. Cheers. Outstanding. All right, guys, we're getting ready to apply our last color in the rainbow here. Now, once we apply this red in the top corner, we're going to give this a few minutes. Now, all of this is starting to dry out a little bit, but we've got to give the red a few minutes to dry out as well. So we'll kind of like chat. Maybe I'll tell a fun story while we're letting that dry. So, and I've got a few of them. I can either tell you some military stories. I can tell you some stories from when I worked at DC Comics and Mad Magazine. There's some fun stuff in there too. I'll come up with a fun story, but we're gonna put this red in here in just a second, and then we're gonna give it a minute to dry before we put in our trumpet flowers and our hummingbird to finish this thing up. So hopefully all of you are having an absolutely amazing time tonight and painting along with me and enjoying yourselves. You're more than welcome to come back any Friday night that you'd like. I'm here every Friday, 9 p.m. Eastern time. Doing a different painting every week, an original new painting every week. So this is not something that you've painted with any of the paint and sip companies. I do all my own originals, so I don't run into any problems with them. So come on back and paint with me any Friday that you'd like. Just really simple, some paints. You need your primary colors, black and white. You need a palette, which is a styrofoam plate, a couple of brushes, and some water, and a canvas. And Michaels has a great deal on these right now. I just bought like 10 of these for like $11. They had 2 5-packs on sale. It's crazy. And I don't get paid by Michaels to say that. I just mean they've got some great friggin' sales, and they don't discriminate against people either, like that other shithole that I don't visit. Whatever. You know what I'm talking about. All right, guys, let's go ahead and wash out our brushes and get them nice and clean. I've got a clean large rectangle brush here, and now I'm going to go ahead and start putting some red into the corner of my canvas. I'm just put some red on my brush like that, and I'm just going to come up in here and I'm just going to start sweeping my red across. All right. Now, again, just like everything else I've done, I am going to be applying some water. So I want to leave a little bit of gap there. I want to give some room for the water to kind of like wash down. I don't want to cover that whole thing and make it all red, just a solid red. I want to be able to let some water flow a little bit. So now that I've got a little bit of red up in the corner, I'll grab some water and I'll just start washing some of that down a little bit. Bring some color in there, bring some water in. I can bring some water up in the corner. All right, and if that water thins out some of your paint that's up in the corner, that's absolutely okay. It's absolutely okay. Let that happen, all right? This is where I get a little Bob Rossian, all right? Just let these little accidents happen. Just let it happen. Just bring it in. Just bring that color in. Let the color enjoy where it's going, all right? Let it explore a little bit, all right? Let it move across your canvas. Maybe the red wants to go on vacation down by violet for a little bit. So just let it kind of move across the canvas a little bit. All right. There you go. Just let that happen. Just like that. Okay. And once we've got our red in place, you can go ahead and wash out that large rectangle brush. And what we are going to do is kind of take a breather for a second. We're going to stop and relax a little bit. We're going to let that red dry, because what we want to be able to do is have a nice dry piece of canvas to put our trumpet flowers and our hummingbird. Now, granted, our trumpet flowers and our hummingbird are also sort of weeping with that color, okay? But we want to get the base colors in there first before we start applying that water, which means some of this needs to be fairly dry underneath. So we're going to give that a minute to dry. And I guess what I'll do is I'll tell you guys a story. What the hell? Why not? First of all, before I got a great story about one time I was working at Mad Magazine. But did you guys see the news today? Apparently, there was like an explosion at a cheese factory in France. Did anybody see that? There's nothing left but debris. Okay, enough of that nonsense. All right, guys, so funny story, story time. As one of my friends on TikTok would say, there's a guy named Feral Sai, who's a, I think he's a, an Army Sergeant Major. Maybe, I don't know, he's maybe a Sergeant Major. I'm not sure how that works over there in the Army. But anyway, he's 78, whatever. But he does story time, and I'm sorry, Sai, for stealing this from me again. Story time, here we go. I've got a story, but it's not one of my military stories. It's going to be one of my Mad Magazine stories. So, I'm in the office one day. I'm just sitting at my desk, just messing around. You know, I'm probably working on an article for one of the issues, you know. And one of our executives comes through taking a VIP tour. You know, we got VIP tours. Some of you have come and visited me out at DC Comics when I worked there. So I gave you guys tours. You know, it's the same thing. But this time it was like a VIP. It was a Hollywood type doing a tour. And my friend Dan was giving the tour, and you know, we were walking through, and I didn't see who it was because I wasn't paying attention. But I saw the person walk into the art director's office and close the door. And Dan was just standing outside. And then there was a woman and two kids also standing outside. They had been left outside the art director's office. I'm like, that's weird, but okay. So the wife and the two kids are talking to our production artist, to Burn. So, you know, what about this, and what about this, and what can you tell us about this? And Burn is answering the questions. Doing a great job, but then they started asking some historical questions, and Burn said, you know what, I don't know the answers to this. Why don't you talk to Michael? He's our assistant art director, and he's reorganizing the archive right now. He may be able to answer your questions. So the woman and the two kids come over, and we just start talking about Spy vs. Spy, and we talk about Mad TV, we talk about Sergio Aragonés, and we're just talking about Alfred E. Newman, everything. And I'm enjoying just chatting with the kids. They're really adorable, really fun, smart kids, but very quiet. The wife is super energetic, really like, you know, very, you could tell, like, whoever she is, she's with somebody because she's got that energy. Like, you know, she's definitely got that energy where she's dealing with a celebrity every day, all right? Like, she knows how to deal with the celebrity bullshit. That's what I'm getting at. So, about 20 minutes go by, and I hear the art director's office open up, and I don't look because I'm talking to the wife and the two kids, and I don't want to be rude. But then I see this like this monolith sort of walking towards me out of the corner of my eye. And the wife goes, oh, by the way, I'd love for you to meet my husband. And she turns her head like this, and I turn my head like this. And it's fucking Terry Crews. You know, like Terry Crews standing in front of me. And so we introduce each other. You know, hi, I'm Mr. Crews. And he goes, no, call me Terry. And I'm like, well, I'm Michael, and you know, back and forth. And we just start talking about, again, Spy vs. Spy. He loves Spy vs. Spy. He's a big fan of it. We start talking about the history of the magazine and Bill Gaines and all this fun stuff. And I tell him what I do with the magazine, you know, how I help with the articles and I do some animation and whatnot. And he tells me about how he's building a computer with his teenage son. That's how they're bonding. They're actually building a gaming computer from the ground up. And I'm a little jealous because I've never done that before. I think that's friggin' amazing. And then we're just sitting there talking, just having regular people conversation. And I can't do this. I don't know if I can even. But he just starts going, boink, 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 with, you know, how he does the peck thing. Just, like, subconsciously. And I look at him, I'm like, did you just peck boink me? He goes, oh, sorry, I just, yeah, you just do that. Whatever, okay? So now I feel like I called Terry Crews out on his, like, peck boinking, and it's a little weird, but it was one of the most fun days that I ever had. I ended up giving him a hardcover edition of one of our Spy vs. Spy books, and he's like, oh, I can't take it, I can't. I'm like, no, trust me, we got a whole box of them, take it, enjoy it. But when you get home, take a picture of it, all right? Take a picture of you holding it, send it into us, let us put it in the magazine. He was like, gotcha, no problem. And sure enough, within a day or two, we had a picture of Terry Crews holding the Spy vs. Spy, the explosive edition of Spy vs. Spy, in his foyer there, and we actually put it in the upcoming edition of the magazine. So if you ever see that picture of Terry holding that book, That was the book that I gave him that day that we met and chatted for a good 45 minutes straight. My friend Dan was sitting in the background, really not happy. He's like tapping his watch. What do you want me to do, Dan? I didn't stop him. Terry's talking to me, all right? I can't just go, hey, you know what, Terry, get the fuck out of here. I can't do that because he'll peck me. He'll do the boop, boop, boop. He'll peck me. I can't do that. So there you go. Fun little story about Terry Crews. I hope you guys enjoyed that. So I'm going to go ahead and take a minute to just look at my comments here. Doesn't look like we got any new comments. I hope you guys are enjoying yourselves and having a really good time here tonight. Let's go ahead and get ready for our next step. But before we do that, I will go ahead and share another toast with you guys. And this toast kind of applies to, it really applies to the pandemic. Back in the days of, you know, my Navy days, it meant something entirely different. But now that we're in the pandemic, it really, like, it's opened itself up and it applies to everybody, civilians, military, it just applies to everybody. So, here's to staying positive and testing negative. Cheers. And if you've ever served in any branch of the military, you know exactly how that applied 20 years ago. There you go. All right, guys, this next step, what I want to create next, is actually these trumpet flowers. And I'm creating the trumpet flowers first so that I have a focal point for the hummingbird to be facing towards. All right, now all of this stuff here is really simple, basic shapes, nothing too complicated. All right, but I am switching brushes right now. I am going to be picking up my small round brush this time. All right, get a little bit of water on that. Nom, 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 nom. Okay, and my trumpet flowers are a little bit of blue and a little bit of purple with some white sort of in the throat right there. So what I want to do is I'm going to pull a little bit of white onto my palette first because I want to set up that circle of white. And the reason I want to set up that circle of white for each one of these first is I know where to pull back from to come back to where the flowers all initiate. So I'm going to take a little bit of white on my small round brush here. Put it upside down. And I'm just going to pick three spots, like right here in the middle of my canvas. And I'm just going to make some rough sort of oval-shaped circles. All right? They don't have to be perfect. They're not real circles. All right, remember, this is an abstract painting, guys. And we're going to be washing color and letting it drip down. So they don't even have to be like solid circles, all right? They're just sort of blobs of white paint on my canvas, just like this here. Blobs of white paint, three of them, okay? And what I want to do with those is once I've got those in place, what am I going to do next? I'm going to take some of that water, some of that clean, bright water, and I'm just going to start applying that water into the white paint and letting that white paint start to drip down, all right? That white is going to drip down the same way all the other colors did. Just add some white to that. Grab a little bit of, just let that white paint drip down. Let it soften up. Let it become loose, friendly as it moves around. Just like that, okay? How are we doing so far? Anybody got any questions? All right. Any concerns? Outstanding. Thank you again, all of you that are here tonight. I really do appreciate you being here. I hope you all are having a really, really good time and enjoying yourselves. Again, I'm here every Friday night at 9 p.m. Eastern, right here on TikTok and Instagram Live, Falk This Nonsense, F-A-L-K, This Nonsense, and over here on Facebook Live, MC, that's Mike Charlie Foxtrot Alpha Lima Kilo, MC Falk over on Facebook Live. All right. So there we go. We've got our white dots. We've got our white, the throat, our white circles in here. Now it's time to pick up some of our purple. Let's go back to the purple that we have in here from earlier. All right, if you don't have any purple left, you can mix up a little bit more with some blue and some red. All right. And all I'm really going to do here is I'm going to outline these flowers in purple. I'm going to outline them in purple and fill them in with blue so that I get a nice mix of color. So I'm going to start on the top and the bottom of each circle, and I'm just going to sort of draw a long pointy hat backwards from it. Just like that. Long pointy hat. All right, and just so you guys can see how that's going to look on the next one, I'll take the next one, top and the bottom, just like that, and I'll draw another long pointy hat, only this time I'll draw it back to where my other flower came from, just like that. long pointy hat. Okay? So now I've got two long pointy hats. Let me do my third one. You'll see this start to come together here in just a moment when we add the blue. But right now we're just adding the outline of the trumpet flowers. Now, if you know anything about hummingbirds, you know that they absolutely love trumpet flowers and trumpet-shaped flowers. They can get their beaks in there really, really easily and just get all the pollen and the nectar out. I used to have hummingbird feeders out west, and I loved videotaping them, but they actually enjoyed some, like when our honeysuckle was blooming, they actually preferred the honeysuckle flowers to the hummingbird feeders. They actually enjoyed them a lot more. So it was good to see that. All right, so I've got my I got my small round brush again. I still have this, and I've got my outline of my purple flowers here. Now I'm gonna come in with some pure blue. All right, I'm just gonna bring some pure blue right into the middle. Just let it go right over some of the purple. All right, I wanna make sure that you can see some of my orange and my yellow behind there. I don't wanna cover that up. I want a little bit of a gap in between each flower, but I'm just gonna fill this in with some blue. Now, in other words, I'm not being really precise or careful. And the reason I'm not being very precise is because I'm gonna wash it all down with some water, right? So, now I will go ahead and switch out to my large rectangle again. And the reason I'm switching out to my large rectangle is I can apply a little bit more water to some of this pink here. So go ahead and take that brush, a little bit of water in there, and just start dropping some of that water on top of the purple and the blue pink that I put down. And you can start to see how that wash starts to flow down into the colors underneath. Now the flowers start to wash down into all the rest of our color as we move along here. We got some nice purples and blues sort of washing down. Got some of that white that's still washing down. And then we're gonna wash out our large rectangle brush and set it aside. Time to take a breath, all right? I feel like I've been talking a lot, maybe rushing around a little bit too much. Oh, Anita, I'm sorry, I apologize, I just saw that. Can you see that a little bit better? So I've got one of my viewers over on Instagram is asking if I can do this a little bit closer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shift my cameras a little bit really quickly so that we can see stuff a little bit closer. So let me move my cameras. Just, I'm going to move all three cameras here. Just give me a second, guys. So we can see these up close. You won't get to see my pretty face, which I don't think most of you want to see anyway, but you will get to see the painting up a little bit closer. All right, so there's those of you on Instagram a little bit closer. Let me get Facebook locked down here just a little bit. Make an adjustment. I don't have a camera person right now, so you know, I wish I had like the whole like studio Bob Ross thing going on, but you know how it is, it happens. So there we go, there's our up close. Anid, can you see that better now? Does that help? Outstanding. I'm sorry about that. I apologize that I missed that when I did. So what we're gonna be focusing on next here in just a moment, guys, is we're gonna be working on our hummingbird. So I've kind of like set the cameras on this area of the canvas right here. You guys don't need to see me anymore, right? So let's go ahead and take a breather for just a second. If you need to change out your water, go ahead and change out your water because we are going to be using a few colors for the hummingbird here. Take a breather, relax a little bit. When I come back, we'll do another toast, maybe a fun joke, maybe a fun story, and then we'll move on to the hummingbird. How does that sound? All right? Outstanding. Thanks, guys. Be right back. I'm going to change my water out as well. Thank you.
sunglasses at night. I wear my sunglasses at night.
All right, so as we get ready for the next step, what I want you guys to make sure that you've got is a clean brush. We're going to be using our small round brush to start off with here, so make sure that's nice and clean. And we want to make sure that we've got some clean white paint on our palette, because what we're going to do is we are actually going to sort of outline the basic shape of our hummingbird in white and then put color over the top of it to then wash it down. All right, outstanding. Any questions or comments so far? Looking good, outstanding. All right, guys, I'm gonna get ready to move on to the next step here, but again, before I do, I'll share another toast with you guys. Why the heck not? Here's a great one. This is a really, really fun one, and a favorite of mine. See if I can get everybody. I got a Facebook camera there, I got Instagram here, I got TikTok here. Here's to the nights we will never remember. Alongside the friends we will never forget. Cheers. Thanks for being here, guys. And I gotta be honest with you, those of you that are here on the social media platforms with me, I know that many of us have never met. I've met Seamus, I've met Joni, met a couple of you here and there, but there's a few that I haven't met, and I want you guys to understand that, yeah, we're friends. I'm enjoying every minute of this. I'm having a blast. So thank you for being here. Jane over here, I know that I've never met you, Jane, on TikTok there, but you keep coming back week after week and you're painting with me and you know, you're toasting with me, and I do appreciate that. So we're friends, and I appreciate you being here. So thank you very much. All right, guys, here's what I'm getting ready to do. Now, I know I'm a little close to the camera. You guys can't see my pretty face. I understand. It's probably for the best. But what I'm getting ready to do now is lay out the hummingbird, okay? Now, again, just like when we did these circles here for the throat of the flowers, these don't have to be perfect circles. These don't have to be perfect shapes. Usually, if we're doing a circle or oval, I would show you the technique that's really easy. I'd show you a little wagon wheel and show you how to get a perfect circle or a perfect oval. We don't need to worry about that, all right? What we're doing here is a nice, rough, basic shape because we are gonna be washing that color right on down the same way we've been doing all night. So I'm gonna come over here, and right here in the middle flower, my hummingbird is gonna be taking nectar from the middle flower. So about an inch or so off that middle flower, I'm just gonna come in here and make sort of a rough oval shape. Nothing perfect, just a loose, rough oval shape for a head, just like that, okay? And then off of that rough oval shape, I want to make his body. Now, his body doesn't come straight down. It doesn't come straight out. It sort of comes out on a diagonal like this. It's an oval that comes out on a diagonal. All right? This is my hummingbird's body, just like that. And then down off the back, we'll do his tail. It's just a straight line, just like that. Okay? Now, I know this doesn't look like much just yet. Give it a second, and we'll get there. So before we do the wings, I want to go ahead and start adding some color to my hummingbird so I can see where he is and where I need to put the wings. So I've got this basic white blob on the canvas, and I want my now this is my hummingbird, guys. I painted a green hummingbird with sort of blue and purple wings, all right? Your hummingbird can be any color you want it to be. If you want to make a red hummingbird or an orange hummingbird, please. Play with the colors, enjoy them, all right? Let them move around the canvas a little bit. I'm gonna go in this time with a blue hummingbird. I'm not gonna do a green hummingbird. I'm gonna go back to my blue. I'm gonna pull some of my straight blue here, and I'm just gonna put some blue. I'm gonna put a line of blue on the top of the hummingbird's head, just like that, like a little hat, and I'll do a little bit on his back, just like this. Bring it down his back and down to the tail. Now, why am I only putting it on the top like that? You guys know, you've been painting with me all night. You know exactly what I'm gonna do next. I am going to pull some straight water. I'm gonna use my large rectangle brush again. This guy right here. I'm gonna pull some straight water onto that. and I'm just gonna start dabbing in some water on top of that blue and letting it wash down over the white and over the rest of the canvas. Let that color wash through there. Okay. Now remember, this is an abstract painting, all right? So don't be afraid to let it look unusual and otherworldly, all right? It's perfectly okay. Now you can see that I've got a rough outline of a hummingbird there, okay? Nothing too concrete or solid yet. You gotta put the wings on. Let's take a breather for just a second. Wash your brushes out, relax a little bit. I don't wanna get too far ahead of you guys. I'm gonna check my comments. If anybody's got any questions about how I just did that, if you need me to back up and do it again, I'll do it again. Please let me know, all right? Checking Facebook, I don't see anything going on over here. Instagram, cheers, Need, thank you. Janie, over here on TikTok, thanks. I hope you don't mind me, Jane, I hope you don't mind me calling you Janie. It's just, it clicks with me for some reason, so. Oh, did you? Jane, I'm sorry, I missed that. I just saw your message. You met me in Encino, really, my last class in Encino. I'm sorry, I apologize, I didn't realize that. That's outstanding, thank you so much. Jane, wasn't the hummingbird your idea last week? Am I remembering that correctly? I am so sorry, I apologize for not remembering that, Jane. But thank you for coming back and painting with me. This is awesome. And just in case you were wondering, yes, I am still wearing my kilt. I've gotten to the point now where I'm just like, I've been wearing my kilt for a month straight. I take it off at night, put it back on in the morning, just because it's easy and comfortable. Okay, outstanding. How we doing, guys? Everybody okay so far? Jane and Anid and Joni, I see you guys are like consistent with your comments and whatnot. Are you guys going okay? Doing okay? Am I moving too fast? Is everything all right so far? So I'm curious, Jane, if you don't mind chatting with me for just a moment in the message here. So you and I obviously met in Encino when I was back teaching Paint Night Live, and I love that you're back here now and interacting with me on TikTok, but how did you find me? Did you just like come across me maybe on like Facebook or Instagram and then come over to TikTok, or did you find me on TikTok and say, hey, I know this weirdo? I'm just curious. I just want to know how my stuff is getting out there. Next MRV. Over here on TikTok. Thanks for being here, man. You're coming in at the end of our painting, and I apologize for that. But I do a new and different painting every Friday night at 9 p.m. Eastern. I walk people through painting stuff step by step. So if you want to come back and paint with me next Friday, I'd love to have you. You're welcome to finish watching what we're painting here. We're painting this beautiful rainbow hummingbird here, and you'll see it start to come together in just a moment. But if you want to come back and paint with us next week, I'd love to have you. All right, guys, I'm going to grab my small round brush here again. And this time I'm gonna do the wings on my hummingbird. And I used purple on this other one here, but I think this time, because I used blue on the body, I think this time I'm gonna use a little bit of green for the wings. So I gotta mix up a little bit more green, and I'm running low. Starting to dry out a little bit. So I'm gonna take some blue and some yellow, just bring it over here. Mix the two together and make a nice soft green, okay? And the same way I did the body of my hummingbird, I'm gonna be very loose and relaxed with my wings. I'm just gonna come off like right behind the neck here and just do sort of a long frowny face, like that, okay? And then from that frowny face, I'll come out and just sort of make a wing shape. Just like that. Then we'll do another one right above it. Long frowny face. Not quite as long because it's in perspective. It's in the background, right? And then from there, we'll just finish up that wing with a nice little oval, just like that. Okay? So the two hummingbirds' wings giving us a little bit of perspective or depth there. And then I'll just fill those in with green. Okay? And if I want to be fancy or fun, and I think I do, I think I want to have a little bit of fun with this, I'm going to throw a little bit of straight yellow into the bottom of these wings. Watch this. I'm just going to bring some yellow right in here like this. Because when I add the water and I start dripping this down, it's really going to look wonderful. So I'm just going to throw some yellow right in here. Okay? And then just like I've done all night, I'll grab my large rectangle brush, okay, with some clean water on it, and I'll just come in here and just start dripping some water along the top of all the paint. Let some of that paint wash down. Just tap that water into the paint. And don't be afraid to just let it wash wherever it wants to go, okay? That's the beauty of an abstract, loose, relaxed painting. This paint can go wherever it wants to, and you're not doing anything wrong, okay? You're doing the right thing. We're just creating a beautiful, abstract, relaxed composition, okay? You guys, you may be surprised by my saying this, but I'm telling you, if you take this thing, no matter what you think it looks like, if you take it and hang it up in your living room, people are going to think that you bought it somewhere. And then you can go ahead and tell the story about how you painted it all on your own. Okay? Trust me. You will really be surprised at how people interpret art. Especially when you don't tell them. You just like let them see it. And like, oh, beautiful. Trust me on that. All right? Hang it up in your living room and see what people say. But there we go. We've got some nice, beautiful greens and yellows starting to float down here. I think I need a little bit more, maybe some green or some yellow right in here. I can add a little bit in there. And then I can add a little bit more water, sort of drip it down a little bit. Oh, look at that. There we go. If at any point you're running out of, like if the water drips too much paint down, you can absolutely add more paint. Just to kind of like fill an area in, like I'm doing here. And let that paint drip down a little bit. I like this technique. This is a fun technique. This is like my second favorite technique. If you guys have painted with me before, as obviously some of you have, I like the flicking effect. That's one of my favorites. It was taught to me by somebody, a good dear friend, is very important to me. I've been painting my entire life and I'd never seen it before. And when she taught that to me, I was like, oh, it was amazing. So I use it all the time now. It's my favorite painting technique to flick. I can make snow, I can make stars, I can do anything with that. So this is my second favorite like this. So hopefully you guys are enjoying it as much as I am.